Let's talk about exchange rates. You know, those numbers that tell you what a currency is worth. But what if I told you there's a hidden story behind those numbers? We're going to dig into the difference between what a currency's value seems to be and what it actually means for you and me and the real world. So picture this. You see a news headline that says the US dollar has gotten, say, over 16% stronger against another currency this year. Sounds simple, right? A pretty big win for the dollar. But is that really the whole story? Not by a long shot. First up, let's talk about the number we all know and see every day. It's called the nominal exchange rate. This is the rate you see on the news, the one you get at the currency exchange booth at the airport. It's just a straight-up comparison of one currency to another.
Okay, let's use a real example. Let's say at the start of the year, one US dollar buys you 3 Israeli shekels. But by the end of the year, that same dollar gets you 3.5 shekels. Just looking at that, it seems obvious. The dollar got stronger. It buys more stuff, right?
And if you do the quick math, that's a 16.6% jump for the dollar's value. So, case closed? Well, not quite. Because that number only tells you about the currency itself, not about its actual purchasing power. And this is where things get really interesting. We've got to introduce a major plot twist. Inflation. See, the prices of everything from coffee to cars are always changing in both countries, and that has a huge impact on what your money can actually buy. So that leads us to the big question. Is that 16.6% gain real, or is it kind of a financial mirage? To figure that out, we need to bring in the missing data. And here it is. For our little story, let's say inflation in the US was 5.4% for the year, and in Israel it was 3.8%. These two little numbers, they are the absolute key to unlocking the real story here. All right, with this info, we can finally calculate what's called the real exchange rate. This is where we get a much, much clearer picture because it takes into account how prices actually changed in both places. Now, the logic for this is actually pretty simple when you break it down. You start with that basic nominal rate we saw earlier. Then you adjust it for the price changes in the foreign country. And then you adjust it again for the price changes right here at home. So let's see what that looks like as a formula. Here it is. This is the magic formula. The real exchange rate equals the nominal rate multiplied by the ratio of foreign inflation to domestic inflation. This is how we put all the pieces together to see what's really going on. Okay, enough theory. Let's plug our numbers in for the end of the year and see what this formula spits out.
So we take our end-of-year nominal rate, which was 3.5. We multiply that by the U.S. inflation factor, that's 1 plus 0.054, and then we divide it all by the Israeli inflation factor, which is 1 plus 0.038,
and what we get is 3.554. Now, you might be looking at that and thinking, okay, that's not that different from 3.5. And you're right, it doesn't seem like a huge jump. But the real story emerges when we look at the change over the entire year. So for our last step, let's compare this new real rate of 3.554 to where we started, at 3.0, and find out the true percentage change. And there it is. The real change was 18.46%. That's almost 2 full percentage points higher than what the simple nominal rate told us. The dollar's actual purchasing power got even stronger than it looked on the surface. So why does any of this matter? Why go through all this math? Well, because this isn't just some fun number game. This stuff has huge real-world impacts on businesses, on your wallet, and on entire economies. Just look at them side by side. It's so clear. The nominal rate showed us a strong dollar, for sure. But the real rate? It shows that the dollar's actual ability to buy stuff grew even more. That's a nearly 2-point difference that businesses definitely, definitely notice. So what happened? Why was the real change bigger? Well, in our example, prices in the US went up faster than prices in Israel. That difference meant the dollar's real buying power for Israeli goods got an extra boost that the simple exchange rate didn't show. And really, this is the bottom line. If you're running a business and trying to decide whether to sell your goods overseas or buy materials from another country, you don't really care about the nominal rate. You care about the real rate. Why? Because it tells you the truth about your costs, your prices, and your potential profit. So the next time you see a headline with a simple number, just remember the real exchange rate. It's a fantastic reminder to always ask yourself, what's the full story here? What other crucial factors, like inflation, are hiding just beneath the surface?